Hey, Jonah, what's up?
Hey. How's it going?
Hey. Nice to see you.
Hey, how's it going, man?
Yeah, good. How are you, man?
I was doing pretty well, but then I gotta say, I have to ask you, was I your first choice to be on the show tonight?
Of course, buddy. We love having you on.
Yeah, I couldn't help but notice the sign outside my door. It says Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah. Well, I can explain that. Scarlett Johansson is the name of the room.
Right.
Yeah. We named all the rooms, the dressing rooms, after celebrities that I fantasize about.
Okay. Well, really? What's your dressing room called?
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Okay. But the thing is, I also found this card, and it says, "Thanks for coming on the show, Scarlett." And then you also drew like a massive set of female breasts.
Well, I can explain that. Give me a minute.
Listen, you don't have to lie to me. You know, I worked really hard to get where I am, and I consider it a big honor to be on your show. And I don't know. Am I crying now? It's stupid.
No. Come on, buddy. I'll be honest. There was a bit of a mix-up with the book. And Jonah Johansson, you know, it sounds kind of similar. Oh. You should probably change your name. How about Scooter? Scooter.
Okay.
Yeah, if you think about it, the whole mix-up thing is kind of funny. Laugh about it with me. Come on. See? Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess it is a little funny. It's like, why does my gift bag have this pair of panties inside, right?
Yes. Actually, that's not a mix-up. No. I got these for you. Put them on.
Howdy. Don't tell me what I wear.
Yeah. Put them on. That's okay. Put them on. Now.
The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Mazda. Claim your Mazda and the great offers that go with it at the Claim Your Mazda event.
Like as if it were real. That's right. What a fabulous audience. What a really great audience we had last night. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. You're a fantastic audience. You're my favorite audience I've ever had. I think the audience may be a little gullible this evening. Excellent. It's a great day for America, everybody, yesterday. I say that every night, but it's not possible to be a great day every night. It just doesn't make... It wasn't a great day for Lindsay Lohan. Last night, she had another accident, not with her car. This time, she fell into a cactus bush in front. She did. She fell into a cactus bush in front of the paparazzi. I thought she wasn't going to do any more diving into bushes. I thought she was done. Apparently not. There seems to...
Don't you judge me.
Do you know that James Cameron, the guy that directed Avatar in 3D? 3D! All the stoners at home are like, oh, come on, man! James Cameron, who directed the Avatar, he's in a feud with Glenn Beck, you know, the rabble-rouser. Because Cameron called Glenn Beck a madman. James Cameron and Glenn Beck are very different, of course. One makes millions creating fictional worlds and unbelievable stories, and the other one's James Cameron, so they're different. They're not never going to come... Don't you applaud me. Don't you applaud me. Please. Applauding on late-night shows sounds like, yes, you finished the joke. We know you don't have a band, so we're trying to help. I don't want your pity. Madonna announced she's making a new movie about England's King Edward VIII and his pretty American wife. I think it's a perfect part for Madonna, but I don't know who's going to play the wife. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I get oohed for a Madonna joke? What the hell? I'm ashamed. Anyway, the big story today is that one of the Earth's islands has vanished. I'm not kidding about this. It isn't one of those David Copperfield pranks. It's not one of those kind of Salam Catalina things. No, the rising sea levels in the Indian Ocean have caused an entire island to vanish. One day it was here, the next day it's gone. It's like that hole in the ozone layer. Remember that? Anyway, yesterday I stopped using hairspray for weeks. Yesterday, Ben and Jerry were giving away free ice cream. Today, a global warming causes an island to disappear. I'm thinking it's a terrible roller coaster week for Al Gore. But so happy, so alarmed, so happy. The island that... want to clap, but have been shamed into not clapping. I know. Should be ashamed of the clap. Knock it off. Anyway, the island that disappeared is called New More Island. I guess it's called No More Island now. But it's a controversial island. It's been causing trouble between India and Bangladesh because they've both claimed it as their own. They almost went to war over this island. Do we have a map of the area around here? There's India, Narnia, South Narnia, Bangladesh. It's in the Bay of Borat right there. Anyway. Now, the last thing anybody wants is a war between India and one of our neighbors, because India has nuclear weapons, and they've got all the tech support guys that know how to use the Indian. If you know the name of the country, you would like to know. Press one. And the arms race... Don't you love it when you call up the tech support guys and they pretend they're in Idaho? I love that. Yes, I am in a major American city. How can I help you? How about that local team? Anyway, what I'm saying is the arms race out there in India and Pakistan, it's not over. India yesterday, this is true. They said that they are weaponizing chili. That somebody wrote it down. It's true. Look at this. Look, Indian Army develops weaponized chili. I know. I'm like, what? Because when I heard they're weaponizing chili, I thought, well, what is the big deal, really? I've weaponized a bit of chili in my time, you know. There's a bathroom in Austin, Texas that got caught in my blast radius. But what's happened is the Indian Army is taking chili peppers, mashing them up, putting them in grenades. And then apparently these chili grenades are 1,000 times more powerful than tear gas. Aha! The only antidote to the weaponized chili is you cover yourself in sour cream and cheddar cheese.
War just got delicious. That doesn't seem right to say that, does it? What the hell am I talking about? It's not about this. It's about that island that disappeared. It's scary. The ocean. It's scary that I forgot what I was talking about. But the ocean is swallowing up islands willy-nilly. Can you imagine a world without islands? Where would the next CBS Survivor season be? The next 500,000 seasons of Survivor. The tribe has spoken. Please leave IHOP. Been fascinated by islands. It's because I grew up on an island. And then we used to vacation on another island. My family used to go vacation in a town called Millport and an island called Great Cumbria off the coast of Scotland, which is an island. That's right, we would leave one cold, damp island to vacation on a colder, damper island. And Great Cumbria, the island, wasn't really that great. It was like, imagine a prehistoric Greeno with terrible weather and fewer teeth. Ah, islands. That's about it for me with islands, I think. I'm done now. It's the commercials time anyway. I can see it on your clock. It's commercials time. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Craig, you forgot to do up your tie tonight. And I'm like, no, I didn't, actually. Do you know why I didn't do up my tie? Because I don't want to. Do you know how many focus groups are like, Craig, you have to do your tie? And I'm like, no. I get calls today from the head of show business. Do up your tie. I'm like, no. Like, it's a late night show. I'm like, it's not. It's not a late night show. It's a public access show on a network. That's what it is. But we have people who will clap for any reason. At all. We'll be right back.
And now, Craig's Spanish word of the day. Today's word is Isla. Isla.
Isla. You nearly applauded the no applause sign. All right, I can't be mucking around with you people and your hand clapping. I do like to have a warm hand, though. It's lovely when you're in show business, you get a warm hand on your opening. That's always good. Makes you feel like the audience is happy to see you. Should we do the Twitter email thing? Put the jingle up then. On you go.
Twitter is the thing with all the tweets. You and your friends stay in touch, but never meet. So now the time has come to check the tweets.
And your email, partner. Ass mode.
Ass mode. All right, this is a very expensive sign we had made. This is from Kyle. This is an email now. This is an email from Kyle in Orland Park in Illinois. Are you from Orland Park in Illinois?
No, Plainfield, close to Orland.
All right, great, thanks. This is from Kyle in Orland Park, Illinois, and he says, "Hi, Craig. How do I know these emails are even real?" All right, here's an email from Brad in Arlington, in Virginia, who says, "Craig, what does the Late Late Show smell like?" Have you ever been to jail? In here, it smells a little bit. If you like, you've drunk too much, and maybe you had an accident in your pants, and then you get thrown into a jail cell, and you wake up about 4 o'clock in the morning saying, "Oh man, things couldn't get any worse unless I hosted a late night talk show." Smells a bit like that, yeah. Except when, you know, you've got special lady guests here who smell delightful and show business. This is from Linda in Plankington in South Dakota. Plankington, where plankton are originally from. Linda says, Craig, why is it called Jonesing? And who was the first Jones to Jones? Shut up. I don't know. That doesn't make any sense. Why is it called Jonesing when you're coming off drugs? What do you say? Jonesing? You say Jonesing when you really want something. I really want something. I'm Jonesing. Yeah. I think it's just a way of sounding cool when you're pathetic. Well, it doesn't. You can't go, oh, I've no self-control. You want to go, oh, I'm Jonesing. Yeah. Sounds better. It's not about self-control. This is from Steve in Fountain Hills in Arizona. I know we're out of time, I don't care. Says, hey, Craig, I was thinking about trying out for the curling team. It looks easy. What do you think? Let me tell you something, Steve. In Arizona. Not maybe the best place to take up curling. Curling's that. It was invented in Scotland. It's like you you get a rock and you push it across the ice and sweep in front of it. And look, we invented it when we were drunk, right? We didn't think anyone was going to go, oh, let's make it an Olympic sport. You know, we were like, oh, this will be great. Look. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Oh, sweep, 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 sweep. Ah, and then suddenly, somebody's walking by and goes, oh, I am from the International Olympic Committee, and that's just the kind of thing we are looking for. Anyway, we've got to go to a commercial now, so just off you go, and then we'll come back. Oh, guess who's here when we come back? Jonah Hill. I hope he's wearing that thing I gave him. Here, come on. Did I knock you off your thing there? Sorry. All right, everybody settled now then? Hi. Welcome back, everybody. My first guest tonight is in a fantastic movie. It may be the best movie ever made. It comes out this Friday, and I have to say, the actors they used in this movie are the best actors ever in the history of acting. There's been some other plays and stuff that had actors in them, but they're all crap compared to the actors in this movie. These actors in this movie make regular actors look like they're on a soap. The movie's called How to Train Your Dragon. It's in theaters on Friday. Take a look at this.
Watch out, babe. I'll take care of this. The sun was in my eyes, Astrid. What do you want me to do? Block out the sun? I can do that. I don't have time. They bought me. Take the date. You know what?
Please welcome the lovely Jonah Hill, everybody. Jonah. Good. Congratulations on being in such an awesome movie,
thanks,
by the way.
Are you going to mention that you're in the movie as
well? Oh, I forgot I was in the movie, but yeah.
That's why you said...
Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, that's
the actors were so great. Yeah.
But did you wear that thing I gave you?
No. I'm going to wear it to my uncle's birthday party.
Yeah. Probably the best.
What have you been doing?
Well, I'm just, you know, trying to fill time between commercials. They have commercial breaks, and then I try and fill time in between.
Yeah. Just hang out with these lovely people. Yeah.
Well, actually, they're hired hobos.
Yeah. There's a real hobo vibe in here.
Yeah, I know. That's where we get the authentic uriny smell. Yeah. Do you ever ride the rails? Ride the rails?
What's ride the rails?
You know, the hobo life, traveling around America.
Oh, the railroads.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I don't know. No. Not on purpose. Yeah. I've just been working on my tan, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
That's sort of what...
Yeah, you were born here, grew up here, and just kind of, like, stayed here, right?
I grew up here, yeah, and I've been tanning for most of my life.
Tanning,
and
yeah.
That's sort of
You know, in the movie, like, look, they have action figure for that,
You
play in the movie. Look.
I haven't seen this yet.
Yeah, look, there it is.
I'm an action figure.
Look, and there's your little thing, yeah.
That is the coolest thing ever.
No, you know what? Actually,
I'm an action figure.
Actually,
that's crazy. I've never been an action figure.
I told you not to applaud. Why the hell are you applauding?
Yeah.
Actually, yeah. It's the second coolest thing ever. Cause look, there's an action figure of my character from the movie. Yeah, look. Thanks for not applauding.
I don't want to be weird, but my guy is like more handsome than your guy.
Yeah. Yeah, well. Yeah, look. But look, my guy can like.
Your guy in the gay community would be like a bear.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's do a play.
Yeah.
Let's do a play with them, right? Put the camera on.
My guy would be like a twink.
Yeah, okay. Let's have them meet in a bar, right? You do your guy, and I'll do mine. We'll do a little play, right?
Hey, what's up, man?
Hey, how you doing? I just came in from Culver City.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What are you doing in Culver City? Dressed?
I was at a convention.
Yeah, what kind of convention?
Viking.
Viking convention?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool, man. Do you want to go see Greenberg with me later?
Is that the one with Ben Stiller?
Yeah, it's really good.
I love that guy.
I've already seen it.
Yeah. You want to see it again?
I figure we're dressed up as Vikings. We might as well go see an awesome, artsy, hilarious movie.
Yeah, I guess. Hey, did you see that movie with Matt Damon in it?
Which one? Green Zone?
No, the other one.
Which one?
You know,
there's only one Matt Damon movie out right now.
Oh, no, this one was a few years ago.
Oh. School Ties?
Sure.
Okay. You guys ever seen School Ties?
No, I never saw School Ties. Do you want to keep that?
Yeah, I do. I do.
I'm going to keep
that. No, it's cool. I don't want my action figure
voice. Yeah, I really love it. Yeah. I'm going to
I actually did see Greenberg, and it was awesome. That wasn't like a joke about Greenberg. I was just thought it was funny because they were dressed as Vikings.
Yeah, no, that's right.
I'll plug that movie because it was awesome.
Greenberg?
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah, you
guys should see that, too, after you see How to Train
Your Dragon. Yeah, if you need to. What's Greenberg about, then?
Greenberg, let me tell you about Greenberg.
Yeah, right.
Greenberg is about Ben Stiller is a guy, and like, you know, he's kind of he's like in his 40s, and he kind of has nothing going on in his life, and he goes to stay.
It's like me, it's my story.
Exactly, yeah. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it. I think it's hilarious that I'm promoting a movie I have nothing to do with that I just like.
Yeah.
You should also go see Star Wars, because that's an awesome movie, too. And
these people are just happy to be indoors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These hobos don't care about anything except...
As long as it ain't moving and there's a roof, they're happy.
I've never been in a crowd with so many sticks with little bandanas attached to the end.
Little handkerchiefs on the... You never fancied that life, the life of a transient?
Hobo life?
Yeah.
No.
What would you do if you went into the acting, though? What about, you know, kung fu or something?
Yeah, I'd say I'd either do kung fu. I bet if I wasn't an actor, I would probably... I would try and be a photographer. That's what I would try and
be a photographer? Like a paparazzi or an arty one?
I'd be a paparazzi member if I could. That seems like a very dignified lifestyle.
Yeah. That's the classy job to get
into. It's like Annie Leibovitz or paparazzi person.
No.
It's kind of hard to tell.
Paparazzi's the way to go because everybody respects you if you're a paparazzi.
Yeah. It's the closest thing you could, like, you can come to being like an actual like dog or animal or something while still holding down a job and being a member of society.
Yeah.
Like,
well, you mean because they take craps in the street.
I have a story. I was walking. I actually went to the premiere of Greenberg. I swear to God, I don't work for Greenberg. Train Your Dragon is what I'm here for.
Yeah, yeah.
It's an awesome movie.
Yeah, right.
How to Train Your Dragon.
Yeah.
Hey, man. How to Train Your Dragon.
Yeah.
Okay, but the point is, I went and I was walking out, and there was these paparazzi guys, and this one guy goes, "Hey, Jonah, who are you rooting for in the WWF WrestleMania or whatever?" And I was like, "I don't know. I don't know. I haven't watched since I was like a kid." And he just turned off the camera and went, "Damn it." Like, I totally blew his night, because he's like, "I came here to get a WWF quote from Jonah Hill." Like, what the hell? Why would you assume that I knew that, you know?
Well, you did let him down, though, to be fair.
I did.
Yeah,
you know, like, those like bright lights, like the light flicked off. He was, like, all happy and nice, and he turned on the camera. Damn it. And he just turned and walked out on the other end.
But they do that when you do that. See, I very rarely go to any of them Hollywood premieres because I don't get invited. But when I went
I knew that about you.
They're like, "No, don't have him." Yeah. But I went to the How to Train Your Dragon one.
I saw you there.
Right. And all the people are there, the paparazzis on the red carpet and everything. And I was trying to do that thing, looking over my shoulder that all the women do.
Yeah. You looked great.
Thanks, man. And I had pants on and everything.
Yeah. You were fully wearing pants.
You know,
Congrats on that.
Did you do what I did? Because I was going, and I was like, I never go to these, so I tried on a shirt and went, "Nah." And then tried on a different shirt and went, "Nah."
You did?
Yeah, yeah.
You, like, fully...
And then I settled on what I was wearing, so you can only imagine how bad it was. But they ask you stuff that you get nothing. Like, this guy goes to me, "Hey, what do you think about Tiger Woods?" And I went, "What? I'm going to see a movie with my kid. We don't want to talk about Tiger Woods to you."
Right.
And he's like, "I'm like, why are you asking me that now?" And he said, "Well, it's a movie premiere."
Well, what do you think about it?
I don't. I think that
Not to put you on the spot.
No. I'll tell you what I think about Tiger Woods. Yeah. I think now that he's got time to practice, he's going to be pretty good.
Yeah.
You know, because before he clearly wasn't practicing. He was just, you know, sure.
Yeah.
Do you play golf?
No. I'm gonna take a lesson though. My brother and my dad play golf. I hear it's a really hard sport.
I don't know. Curling's the harder one.
I was trying to think of questions that were really weird that I got asked at that premiere. Did you get asked any other weird ones?
Nah. Somebody asked me where did I think I was going.
Yeah.
Like, but that wasn't the... I was an usher at the movie. He was like, where do you think you're going? I said, I'm in the movie. He went, it's an animated movie. I said, I'm a voice in the movie.
Well, you know Jay Baruchel, who's in How to Train Your Dragon?
Yeah, he was
awesome.
Here last night, yeah.
You guys could go see it. They were like, "You and Jay have worked together like 5 or 6 times." And Jay and I were knocked up together. We were two of the buddies who live in the house, and we've been in How to Train Your Dragon. And I was like, no, just... knocked up, and How to Train Your Dragon, like, I think you guys have worked together like 5 or 6 times now. And I was like...
Did you think you were lying?
And I was like, no, I'm pretty sure. Like, I know, you know. We've only worked together twice. And they're like... And then the camera, like, kind of, like, she gets off the mic. She's like, just say, like, you've worked with Jay like 5 or 6 times.
Really?
Yeah. It says here you've worked like 5 or 6 times with Jay.
They wanted you to lie?
Yeah, and I was just like, so Jay and I worked together like 5 or 6 times. I was like, however I can get through this weird interview as quickly as possible.
Hey, we're done.
Yeah.
We're out of time. No, seriously, you and I are out of time.
Oh, we are?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Quick, let's plug the movie quickly.
Sorry.
Get your guy going.
Oh, okay, cool.
All right. How to Train Your Dragon, everybody.
Go see How to Train Your Dragon on Friday. Craig is, you're hilarious in it.
Yeah, Jonah's good too, I suppose. All right, Jonah Hill, everybody.
Thank you, guys.
Very much. Do it now? You want me to do it now, or do you want me to do the TV show? Do the TV show? Well, I call it a TV show. It's not. So, in a real TV show, what happens is that they do a countdown, and then they go, coming back to you, studio, and they count it all down, and everyone gets excited, and we get started. What I do is I finish my conversation, and then I say hi, welcome back. Which is probably a bit rude, actually, so I'm sorry. I won't do that again. My next guest is a beautiful actress, and when I say beautiful, I mean attractive sexually. Why lie? She stars in the CSI Miami, which is on Monday nights on CBS. CBS. CBS, Earth's logo, we're not cool. Take a look at this.
Well, unfortunately for you, the only person who can corroborate your story is your boyfriend.
If I knew how crazy he would be, I never would have told him where we were.
Maya, the more you withhold information from me, the harder it becomes for me to believe you.
Clearly, that's where the money goes.
Please welcome the lovely Emily Procter, everybody. Emily Procter.
Emily!
Hey!
You look sensational.
Oh, my God, you're sweet.
No, I'm telling you, look great. Look at all those zips all everywhere and everything. That's awesome. You just want to...
Well, you know, it makes me feel good to hear you say that, because in my bag, I have a giant T-shirt, and I was like, is this a sign? You gave him tiny panties
and
gave me a big
shirt. No, well, what happened was... I should do the gift bags myself more often. Sorry about that.
You're like, it's a day of apologies.
It is. It's like my first marriage. I apologized for years. Hey, do you remember this? We were in a film together.
Years ago. I did. I remember I got the script. I absolutely loved it. And it was you, and you had a partner. Where's he? Where's that guy?
No, I was playing a gay man in the movie. I'm not actually. Well, you know.
Wasn't he your partner? No. The guy who directed the movie? Weren't y'all like a comedy team? Am I drunk?
Well, we worked together on the movie because it required us to do that, but we didn't all live in the same house. It wasn't like the Monkees or anything, you know? You work with David Caruso,
I live
right?
I with David.
You live with David Caruso? Does he go like, what's for breakfast?
And absolutely. All that kind of stuff? And he's in a robe.
Well, what? Does he do that?
Yeah, he does.
You don't shoot that in Miami, do you?
No, we're here.
Do you like
here.
Miami? I've been
well,
there.
That's why I was so surprised, because we're you know, CBS down the street. And when I showed up today, I was like, hey, CBS here is really nice. It's like a big building. I had
what,
no
this
idea.
One?
Yeah.
Good God, woman, what is the other one like? This is the nice one?
This is the nice one. Let me tell
really?
You, like, walked in, it's like you have hand sanitizer, and they've clearly afforded you a bottle for your desk.
Yeah, I got it. Well, I got my cup here, but to be fair, that was a gift. And then I got my hand sanitizer, but I bought that myself.
And then you have yourself as an action figure.
Yeah, I got my action figure here.
You're looking really good.
That's like
a very sexy one they gave you.
Yeah, look at that. Hey.
Good posture.
Yeah. Did you see that movie yet?
I have not seen that movie. I thought maybe you'd ask me to go.
Yeah. Do you want to go see it?
Let's do it.
All right, then. you know what you should see? Go and see that movie with Ben Stiller and everyone's talking about. What's that called? That Greenberg? Yeah, everyone's going crazy for that movie.
We'll just have a marathon. We'll watch some CSI Miami and then...
Yeah. You're the crime solver in the movie. Everyone's very attractive in the crime solving business there. Because whenever I've met a cop, they've always been, well, beating me up. But still...
It's funny you should say that, because I was talking to our showrunner today, and she's like, you know, season 9, what should we do? And I was like, cleavage. I think it's what we do best.
Yeah. There's a reason.
You're nodding.
There's a reason why it's the number one show on TV, and I think cleavage is going to keep you there another couple of years.
You know what?
I'm worried
not?
About not Caruso cleavage, though. I don't need that.
Yeah, you've not seen it. It's very good.
How do you know I've not seen it?
I don't know.
No, maybe he bent over something and I caught a little ass crack, maybe.
Zone 3?
Yeah. Have you ever seen that? Like, is David Caruso ever on the set, like, bent over and you've seen a bit of the ass crack and gone,
I shouldn't be looking, but I must.
I'm drawn to it like a magnet. Probably. I'm trying to think.
You must have seen his ass. You've worked with him for 9 years.
There's a lot of grip crack. That's what I get a lot.
Yeah, the grips that put down the tracks for the cameras, they tend to like to show you the tops of their asses.
They do. And then they take filthy pictures of themselves with your phone, and you get them later, and you're like, oh God. I should be admitting this on TV. Can we start over? Can I go back?
No. Just undo a zip. No one will die. Do you ever, are these pockets in there with those zips, or are they just like bits of you come out if you unzip them?
It's a gift from CBS, so I imagine bits.
CBS give you gifts?
No, they gave you hand sanitizer.
They didn't give it to me. I bought it myself. I brought it in with money I made on the Drew Carey show. Now that was a show. Not like that. Yeah. Were you ever on that show? That was a good show. Yeah.
No. Yeah, just with you, yeah, many years ago.
That was a hairdressing movie we were in.
I loved that movie.
Yeah, so did
I. I thought it was really great.
Yeah, me too.
It's funny, in the credits I'm listed as playing myself, though, which I think is really strange.
Did we not give your character a name?
It had a name. Well, maybe it didn't. Yeah. I don't know.
You were the bitchy receptionist at the hairdressing.
And that's what I thought. I thought you're listing me as myself for being
the bitchy receptionist. That's clearly a foresight that my partner made when the...
We
worked together. I wrote the movie with a buddy of mine, and then another buddy of mine directed the movie, and we all worked together. But we weren't partners, you know.
You were not in love. That's what you're saying to me. You didn't love them the way you love Jonah.
No, I did. I loved them in a bad way.
Did you give them the undergarment?
Panties? Yeah, I couldn't afford panties back then, so I just. Hey, wait a minute. Can I see that ring? Wow, look at that. What's that? Is that a plate for a little birdie?
It's generous.
Well, can I just... Look at that ring. It's like a tiny little plate for food. Is that actress portion size? Is that like... It's true, yeah. Look, you can look.
Well, I'll just have something delicious to eat. Use my knife and I'll just cut up some, I'll cut up some arugula. Because I've got a buddy coming over from Culver City. And there you go.
Emily, we're out of time. I know. Is there anything that we would, I can't remember.
We had many things to cover, and we've only talked about underpants and drunken behavior, but I think it's late night, so that works.
Yeah, and also that's pretty much this show, you know. We like to try and plug as much as we can the Ben Stiller movie that's out right now.
I'm excited for you that you have a movie out. I think that's wonderful.
It's not really my movie. You know, I do a voice in it.
I don't know. You have an action figure. I don't have an action figure from the Big T's.
You didn't get your action figure?
I didn't.
Nah, we didn't make any. It's money on that movie. Now, we're out of time. But listen, congratulations on the CSI, ma'am. It's an enormous hit and continued success. And more cleavage is fine. The lovely Emily Procter, everybody. We'll be right back.
Qué lástima.
Hey, I'm really sorry to Vivi Brown. My apologies to Vivi Brown. We'll have her back very soon. It was Jonah's fault. He kept talking too long, and then Emily kept talking, and she was all, you know, wearing that dress, and I was like, what? Okay.
I'm back.
I'm sorry. Good night, everybody. Good night.